Good afternoon, students. This is Krishna Zoology. So today, so I take subject is topic is human embryo development and also fertilization. So this is important to IPA and also competitive purpose. So this is the 8 marks question is there in IPA. So now we discuss about the fertilization. So what is mean fertilization? So the fertilization means fusion of male and female gametes is called fertilization. Fusion of male and female gametes is called is fertilization. So the fertilization takes place is ampullary isthmic junction. Ampullary isthmic junction. So in the first, during the coitus, sexual intercourse, so the sperm is released into the female vagina through the penis. Penis, coitus, the penis released sperms into the female vagina. So these sperms, motile sperms, so it is swim rapidly through the cervix and enter into the uterus. So that is reached the ampullary isthmic junction. Ampullary isthmic junction. So and it is wait for the egg. So this is about the sperm. Next, ovum. So the ovum also released from the ovary. So after ovulation, the ovum is collected by fimbriae and enter into the impedimentum, ampulla. So ovum also reach the ampullary isthmic junction. So this is the fertilization takes place. Now, well, the sperm reach to the ovum. So the sperm is makes its way into the ovum through so the external membranes of ovary, which is cumulus external membrane and zona pellucida and corona radiata. So this is way to the reach the ovum. In this process, first the sperm when reach the ovum, the acrosome released hyaluronidase enzyme. Hyaluronidase enzyme. The hyaluronidase enzyme released from the acrosome. So this is involving the dissolve of cumulus layer corona radiata. So now this is reached here. So next, the acrosin enzyme released from the acrosome. So this is dissolve the zona pellucida. This is dissolve the ground substance of zona pellucida. So the numerous sperms enter into the pre-vital space. This is called as pre-vital space. So in this space enter numerous sperms. So of these, only one sperm enter into the reach the ovum. So hence it is called monospermy. Human fertilization is monospermy means the numerous sperms enter into the pre-vital membrane space, pre-vital space, but only one sperm enter into the ovum. Hence it is called is mono. Mono means single sperm. So this is about the monosperms. And when the sperm enter into the ovum is started. So this is induced the meiosis division. The secondary oocyte start meiosis, complete the meiosis 2 division. So this is the secondary oocyte, before the secondary oocyte, so it is not fully mature because of it is arrested at the metaphase in the meiosis 2. So when the sperm enter into the ovum, this is induced by this entering and complete the meiosis 2 division. So the result is formation of secondary polar body. So for example, this is the secondary oocyte. So it is complete its meiosis division. Result is here. So this is the tiny secondary polar body. Secondary polar body. This is the mature oocyte and OT. Mature oocyte. So this is also unequal. Hence it is tiny. It is large, haploid, mature female gamete. So that is called oocyte or OT. So this is about the formation of oocyte. Now, so here form mature oocyte and also here there is the sperm. So these both are amphimixes. Both are so fusing. This is called fertilization. So and also called as amphimixes. Amphimixes. Amphimixes means the both are mixing. So and also called synchorion. Synchorion means both haploid nucleus are fusing. So this is about the fertilization and also amphimixes and also synchorion. So when fertilization are complete, so the external corona radiota are disappear. External corona radiota disappear. So this is about the fertilization. Next, so after fertilization, this single diploid cell are called is zygote. So zygote are formed. So now this zygote, so it is needs to enter the uterus for further development, and during the embryo development, so it is complete by different phases of embryo development. First phase is start with the cleavage. So the first phase cleavage. So for the embryo development. So what is mean cleavage? What is mean cleavage? Here the cleavage may. So the cleavage may division, mitotic divisions. So here zygote are formed when mixing of two nucleus. So these zygotes, so mitotic division, the result is increase the numbers. So first this is the single diploid cell. So this is do mitotic division, result two cells, and after dividing to form four cells. So this process is called as cleavage, mitotic divisions. So the human cleavage is holoblastic. The type is holoblastic cleavage. Holoblastic and also indeterminate. And also radial. So what is mean holoblastic? So the holoblastic mean the human egg is microlecithal. So lecithal means yolk, micro means few. So the yolk percent is very low in the human egg, hence total zygote is dividing, hence it is called holoblastic. So next, indeterminate. So indeterminate means so the result of division here increase the number of daughter cells. So we cannot determine future organ from these daughter cells. We cannot identify future organ by these daughter cells. Hence it is called as indeterminate.
Right.
So radial. So the radial symmetry or radial cleavage means. So the radial cleavage means, for example, this is zygote. The cleavage axis. So first, this like first, second, fourth, sixth, eighth. So here axis of division is, so looks radially. Hence it is called radial cleavage. And another one, unequal cleavage. So unequal cleavage mean, this cleavage is unequal means, so by the cleavage. So here form two daughter cells. So one is large, one is small. So it is the daughter cells are structurally not similar. Hence it is called as unequal cleavage. The human cleavage are holoblastic, indeterminate, radial, unequal cleavage. Next of phase. So after cleavage. So next phase is marula. Next phase, marula. So the cleavage is started at the zygote is in the fallopian tube, ampullary isthmic junction. So this zygote needs to, it is moves towards the uterus for further development. So next one is further development. Here, so the cleavage result forming the new cells, new daughter cells. So these new daughter cells are called, blastomeres. Blastomere. So this is about the cleavage. Next phase is marula. So the marula means the embryo with the 18 to 32 blastomere. So that is look a mulberry fruit. Hence it is called as marula. Once again, the marula the means 16 to 32 blastomere marula looks a mulberry shape, mulberry fruit shape. Hence it is called as marula. So the marula looks a solid cell structure. Solid cell structure. So the marula also develops in the fallopian tube and gradually slowly moves to the uterus, towards the uterus for further development. So next, so a process is happened within the zygote, marula. So a process is happened within the marula. So this process is called as compaction. So listen carefully, compaction. So compaction process means, so this is the condensing. So condensing means the cells are reached very closely. So that process is called as compaction. So by the compaction, so result is two types of cells are formed within the zygote. Two types of cells are formed. Two types of cells. So these two types of cells is, outer flattened cell layer, and inner cell mass. So this is called as inner cell mass. So this is first cell differentiation within the human embryo. So this is the first cell differentiation, two types of cells are formed within the zygote. So this is happened by the compaction process. You know, compaction is so condensing. Next, so these outer flattened cell layer also called as trophoblast. Outer, this flattened cell layer is called as trophoblast. So this trophoblast, so it is also called trophoectoderm. Trophoectoderm means feeding, so blast means zygote. So it is further, become the feeding layer to the embryo. So this is about the outer flattened layer, trophoblast. Next, so the trophoblast, so it is forms, trophoblast produce a finger-like projections are called trophoblastic villus. Trophoblastic means, so the marula enter into the uterus, so this is the marula. The marula outer layer is called trophoblast. Trophoblast possesses the finger-like projection. This is called as trophoblastic villi. This trophoblastic villi is entered into the endoderm of uterus for the implantation of zygote. So this is about the trophoblastic villi. Next, inner cell mass. So this inner cell mass, it is becomes next inner cell mass. So this inner cell mass, so it is become the proper, so it is give the proper embryo. So here, so total embryo is formed from the inner cell mass. This is about the marula. Next phase is blastocyst. So now, blastocyst means, so here, so this is the embryo, zygote embryo, this is the trophoderm outer layer, so this is the inner cell mass. So now, so some fluids is enter into the embryo from the uterus. So uterine fluids enter into the embryo. So when fluid is enter into the embryo, the cells of the inner cell mass, so it is divided from the trophoblast. It is separate from the trophoblast. So separate means here gap or form. So separate from the trophoblast. So when increasing the level of incoming fluids, so the marula is acquires the a cyst structure. Cyst means, so that is sac like structure. So finally, when increasing the levels of fluids, so that is separate. So it is completely moves the one side of trophoblast. So this is called as cyst. So totally called as blastocyst. When the uterine fluid enter into the blastula, marula, so the inner cell mass, the formating cells are moves one side. So here forming the cyst, hence it is called as blastocyst. Now, so this cavity within the blastula is called as blastocoel. blastocele, and also called segmentation cavity. Segmentation cavity, and so the cells inner cell mass that is attached to one side of the trophoblast. So this side is called pole, is called is embryonic pole, and embryonic pole, and also called animal pole. So next, the opposite of side of embryonic pole, so this is called as up embryonic pole. Now, so the above the cells of inner cell mass of trophoblast cells are called as rubber cells. rubber cells mean the cells of the trophoblast, so which is attached on the inner cell mass are called as rubber cells. This is about the rubber cells.